According to a devastating report from the United Nations, while the United States is considered the wealthiest nation on Earth, 40 million Americans live in poverty. In a nation that doesn't assure healthcare for all of its citizens, we need to take an important look at the health consequences caused by impoverished conditions. So today, on Brief Brain Facts, we're discussing the detrimental effects of poverty on the human brain. The effect of poverty on the brain is devastating and has often irreversible effects on developing brains, the brains of children, youth, and young adults, as the brain isn't fully developed until about the age of 25. According to the same UN report, 25% of all youths living in the US live in poverty. This is the highest youth poverty rate across all OECD nations. Regarding the causes of poverty, many are prone to point to affected individuals themselves, claiming that poverty is the result of lacking the appropriate motivations to succeed and/or failing to have strong work ethic. However, these claims have been debunked for decades by researchers. They claim that poverty more likely stems from systemic societal issues, including racism, classism, failed social policies, unsafe living conditions, poor education, inadequate laws, and various other societal factors. For some researchers, poverty's effect on the brain while in the womb is considered to be a neurotoxin, a substance that damages tissues within the nervous system, including the brain. Evidence shows that children living in poverty are likely to have brain differences due to four factors, which include exposure to toxins, chronic stress, lack of cognitive enrichment opportunities, and deficient emotional social relationships. While some damaging substances' effects on the nervous system remain unknown, substances like pollution or other toxic substances are often found in impoverished areas. For instance, children in impoverished areas are still exposed to poisons like lead, which never leaves the body and builds up over time. Lead has been shown to damage the central nervous system in developing brains, resulting in behavioral issues like aggression. One known substance that damages the nervous system that is well documented is cortisol. Often, poverty produces high-stress situations. These situations cause the body to release the stress hormone cortisol. In small doses, cortisol can help manage temporarily stressful situations, like taking your college entrance exams. It's a very finite period of time, and the release of cortisol may give you that edge to help you get through that stressful moment. But what happens when you not only have to take a test, but also then have to return to very stressful living conditions? High stress over an extended period of time can result in long-term health issues. As an example, while some recreational drugs are not capable of affecting developing fetuses, that certainly is not the case for cortisol. Extended exposure to cortisol has been shown to influence the neural circuitry of developing fetuses. In other words, a constantly stressed out mother is really bad for developing babies. Further, those same conditions that led to a stressed mother are likely to influence the developing brain of the growing child, as their own cortisol release may damage their developing brain. In a major study looking at the influence of socioeconomic status on the developing brain, the hippocampus, an area of the brain responsible for memory, was significantly smaller in poorer children. Poorer children also had 6% less brain surface area, i.e. less brain cells, than middle class and upper class children. High stressful conditions during childhood due to living in economically impoverished environments has been linked to heart disease, depression, and addiction in adulthood. Behaviorally, repeated exposure to stress has been shown to lead to aggressive behaviors or passiveness, even helplessness. Thus, it's entirely accurate to say that neurons are brain cells that communicate with each other to promote a change or response from the body, develop to reflect their environments, not to pull themselves up by their non-existent bootstraps in order to somehow rise above it. Due to the fact that poverty in society is often treated so poorly, things that could reduce the effects of poverty on the brain, like educational enrichment opportunities, are rarely available in impoverished areas. Children in poverty often have cognitive deficits that are never addressed because they don't have the resources available to them to overcome those deficits. Also, children in poverty often have impaired social relationships. These cognitive and social deficits often sets them up for failure in adulthood, as they aren't as able to effectively and successfully navigate society as are their more wealthy peers. Research has also shown that individuals dealing with very limited resources, i.e. trying to juggle an already stretched financial budget, are so preoccupied with resource maintenance that they have very little time to expend cognitive energy on anything other than trying to secure resources. Thus, they're unable to focus attention attention on getting out of their impoverished circumstances through education or any other means. Moreover, behavioral evidence suggests that people who grew up in poverty could lack empathy as adults. These effects of poverty on the brain have been well documented for decades, so much so that within the research community, there's a widespread consensus that poverty often creates an inescapable cycle, and this cycle stems from brain differences. This reality challenges the belief that the poor are to be blamed for their often cyclical circumstances. In fact, this notion has been so thoroughly debunked that researchers are making efforts to address policymakers so that society can begin to address economic disparities. As these disparities have generational effects, knowing the evidence, it's time we took a stance against the bootstrap narrative regarding those in poverty, because this messaging has really only benefited wealthier people. Those who live with the stress of poverty simply cannot bootstrap their brains into becoming more like the brains of wealthier individuals. How do you think society should address poverty? Comment below. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to our channel and make sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching.